So let's sit on the booster, all right? So I want you to try to feel, hey, keep your sit bone touching the booster and relax the knee down to the floor, okay? You try to let touching your tailbone. So you should feel that the tailbone is off from the booster. Only the sit bone, the one that touching the booster. Okay. And sit bone. So sit bone, yeah. So the sit bone touching the cushion and the tailbone is off the cushion. Anyway, let me show you here. So this is your pelvis. All right. So let you know first, hey, I'm gonna come a little closer to you. So as a human being, the pelvic is not straight like this. It's a little bit tilting to the front, okay? Why is that so? Because of as the spinal is have the curve over here. And because of that, this one is a little bit tilting at the front, all right? So over here, this is your pelvic bone. So at the pelvic bone here, if you use your finger and the tip of your finger touching it, you're gonna feel it, all right? And if you try to use the tip of your finger and try to move your finger down, 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 you're gonna feel the pelvic bone. So sometimes over here, what I tell the mother to do, sitting like that, you might not feel much unless you start to come to the half kneeling and you try to feel from the pelvic bone, all the way down, down, down. You're gonna start to feel at your pelvic bone, okay? And from that, as you know, so this one is your sitting bones, both sides, right and left. So if you try to use your hand, touch it, and you start to move the tip of your finger up, 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 you're gonna start to feel the pelvic bone again. Why? I want you to try to work on this thing, like touching from the pelvic bone all the way down to the pelvic, and from your sit bone, and you try to touching all the way up to the pelvic. Because again, I want you to try to touching at your tailbone. And from here, you need to use your imagination that how far from the sit bone to your tailbone. Is this around a fist? Okay, more or less in some cases, but most women, it's just like that. Now, if we're lying down on the back like this, the space between your sit bone and your tailbone, it doesn't change. It's still the same. But whenever you try to be in upright position, like example, you do the squatting. So now the tailbone is a little bit moving backward. So in this way, you open your pelvic outlet by 28%. And what if you stay in all four like this? And the doula or the midwife try to use the technique to gently pressing this one to let the tailbone a little bit up. So this one gonna open even wider.
Yeah.
And because of that, we always tell the mother, hey, you need to try to first, either you try to shaking the hip, or you try to walking. So in this way, you open the pelvic inlet to be wider and helping your baby to drop head down. Now, for open the pelvic outlet, either you do the squat or you try to be in upright position. In either way, all four, still upright position, standing upright position, half kneeling, especially with a half kneeling here, here, and you try to leaning forward. Okay, so all of this, why I want you to know that about the mapping your pelvic bone. So from now on, somehow that try to imagine that what position that I'm doing right now, whether I'm sitting, standing, lying down, do I do my best to facilitate my baby by keep my hips opening all the time. Okay. All right. So, next thing. Pelvic floor muscles. Okay.
Yeah.
You already know that the pelvic floor muscle is from the pelvic bone all the way to the tailbone and from the sit bone to another sit bone. Yeah. So, they're gonna locate like this one, like a diamond shape like this.
Yeah.
Down. So, I'm gonna leave my pelvic bone over here. Think about this diamond shape here, right? So what I want you to feel is gonna be like this down, okay? So whenever you inhale, I want you to really relax the pelvic floor muscles. And whenever you exhale, if you're gonna work on the pelvic floor muscle, you're gonna try to squeezing the pelvic floor muscles and try to narrow that space. Inhale, relax, and exhale, gently squeeze your pelvic floor muscles in and up according to your own breathing rhythm. So if your exhaling is just only 3 seconds, you try to do only 3 seconds. It's best that we're not really going to pushing ourselves that much anyway. This time right now you is this week 38, yeah?
I'm doing next week.
Oh, okay.
I think I'm week
39.
39 probably.
Okay, alright. And because of it is closer and closer to the approximate due date, so we prefer to work on the relaxing the pelvic floor muscles. We're not really gonna keep like squeezing at this time. So what I want you to do, so from here, we sit in this position, relax the shoulder back and down. Inhale and exhale. Roll your shoulder up toward to the ears and relax. Allow yourself to exhale to your mouth. Inhale. And exhale. Two more deep breaths. Inhale and exhale. One more time here. Inhale and exhale. So keep your eyes closed and I want you to bring your full awareness to the base of your pelvic floor muscles. So whenever you inhale, do your best to relax and let go the weight of your pelvic floor muscles down to the ground, down to the earth. For the next 5 deep breaths, I want you to bring your awareness all the way down to pelvic floor muscles, locate between from one sit bone to another sit bone, from the pelvic bone all the way to the tailbone. Every breath you soften and soften the pelvic floor muscles as you try to expand the area of that diamond shape. Inhale and exhale, relax. Inhale and exhale, relax. And slowly from here, keep the tip of your thumb together and keep the tip of your index finger together. So index finger touching and closer to your vagina. Keep your thumb closer to the womb, to your baby. So when you inhale, I want you to visualize you're sending the oxygen, you're sending the positive energy all the way down to the womb, to your baby. And exhale, let go the tension that no longer deserves you down towards to our Mother Earth. And let the Mother Earth to totally support this body. Inhale, sending the positive energy all the way down to the womb. And exhale, let go. So at the end of your each exhaling, letting go all the negative energy that no longer deserves you. Let go all unnecessary thoughts. Let go the worriness, fear. Let go the tiredness, fatigueness. The more I let go, the more I relax, and the better I feel. The more I let go, the more I relax, and the better I feel. I invited you to still keep your eyes closed softly and gently, and we will chant the word "ah" together for 3 rounds. And whenever you say this word "ah," just visualize you sending more positive energy, nourishing your womb, nourishing your baby inside your womb. So chanting the word "ah" when you're exhaling for 3 rounds. And slowly from here, you keep your hands in the prayer position front of your chest. So keep the tip of your 10 fingers touching each other. Somehow allow the space between your palms. We create this space to offer the gratitude and be thankful for the Bhuvaneshwari goddess, the goddess of infinite space that gives us the positive energy from the universe towards to each and every part in your body to create the space within ourselves for the baby inside the womb and to create the space inside our mind and allow us to receive more positive energy. So we're gonna say the word this time, "ooh." I want you to feel the vibration, feel the positive energy at the center of your heart. Let's say the word "ooh" together for 3 rounds. Ooh. slowly from here, just move your prayer hands here. Keep the thumb close to your third eye chakra. Keep your chin closer to your chest. Eyes closed softly and gently. And now we're gonna chanting the word M sound by keep the lips closed. Feel the vibration around your neck, your throat, your face. And let this vibration, this energy move like a spiral from the throat all the way up to above crown of the head. So say the word M sound with the mouth closed for 3 rounds. And slowly open your eyes. All right, so from here, we're gonna try to modify the all four, yeah? So you're gonna keep your knees on the booster. So keep your knees, stay wider than your hip, and you keep your forearm down. All right, so try to keep your palms below your shoulder. And from here, keep the toes up and circle the ankle joint out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Reverse. 1, 2, 3, 4. Good, good. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So from here, neutral back, inhale. And whenever you exhale, push your hip gently forward and round your back from your tailbone all the way to the back of your neck. Press the chin to the chest, gently press the palm toward to the floor. So inhale back to the neutral back. And exhale, allow yourself to make some noise here. Every time you make noise, think about I let go all the tension, all the negative energy that no longer deserves me. Allow each breath to feel peace and calm. Allow each breath to feel more relaxed. So one more deep breath here, inhale. And slowly from here, keep your forearms down. All right. And I want you to just circle your hip from one side to the other side. You might just keep your eyes closed. So try to synchronize your breath with your own movement. Once your breathing becomes slower, your movement should become smoother and slower. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Then reverse the circle, so hip circle now from the other side. This is one of the best position to strengthening the pelvic floor muscles, by the way, because the pelvic floor muscle is really like relief from all the pressure, whether that from the uterus or from the weight of our body. Yeah. So from here, again, because during this time, I prefer more of the pelvic floor relaxation, not the pelvic floor squeezing or strengthening. I want you to stay like this. So you might make a fist and rest your forehead on the fist. And all you need to do for the next 5 minutes, not 5 minutes, five deep breath here. Send your awareness, travel your mind to your pelvic floor muscles, to the basement of your pelvic floor muscle. And let each and every breathing, you are softening the muscles around your pelvic floor. And let go all the tension that no longer deserve that area. When we are stressful, when we are anxiety, when we are depressed, without knowingly, we squeeze our jaw muscles and consequently, our pelvic floor muscles become too tight because it's been contracting most of the time. So this is the great time, the great opportunity to relax these pelvic floor muscles. And yet to do so, try to let go all the tension. Be calm and be peace. One more deep breath here. Inhale. Exhale. So slowly from here, just have a look, hey? You're gonna do one by one, all right? I want you to rest one arm up. And whenever you exhale, you're gonna scoop that arm to the other side. So you can see that the hip is up high. Rest that ear and that arm to the floor. However, I want you to do another four rounds here. Inhale, arms open, right? And exhale, you scoop to the other side. So still, lift the hip up high. Good. Continue. Give me another three rounds and go. Exhale, scoop. Perfect. Inhale up. And exhale. So one more deep breath here. Inhale. And you know what? Then I'm gonna let you rest in this position. So totally relax that arm and that ear. You lift the hip up high. Now, I want you to extend your right arm forward, okay? And completely letting go your entire body weight down to the Mother Earth. Let this Mother Earth supporting this body. And allow the tension to melt down towards to the center of the earth. One more deep breath here, inhale. And now exhale. So you keep your right palm down, then slowly push your body up. Inhale, open the chest. Now you're going to do the same on the other side. Now it's going to be on your right side. Yeah, so inhale, right arm up. And exhale, scoop the right arm, yes, to the left. So right arm, right ear touching to the floor, the hip still up high here. So continue another four rounds. Inhale. And exhale. So three to go. Inhale deeply. And exhale. So one more time here. Inhale. And exhale. So relax the right ear, relax the right arm, and slowly try to extend the left arm forward. So you're totally letting go your entire body weight down towards to the ground. Let the end of each exhaling feel the heaviness of your right arm down to the floor. Feel the heaviness of the head down to the floor. Good, good. Then slowly from here, keep your left palm back and slowly push your body up back to the center. Inhale here and exhale. So keep your palms down. We back to the all four, modify one here. Tuck your toes on the floor. Inhale, whenever you exhale, lift your hip up to downward facing dog. So inhale, rest the knees on the toes. And exhale, so lift the hip up and look to the back of the mat. Keep the feet wider than your hip width apart would be great here. So create more space for your pelvic outlet. Inhale. Exhale. One more deep breath. Inhale. And exhale. So from here, sway your hips side to side. Or you might just circle your hip from left to the right side. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Reverse, reverse. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And of course, let resting just a little bit here. So you keep your knees apart and let the tip of your toe touching each other. So from here, you might just using the booster once again. So now we're gonna try to rest our chest and our face. So your hip is gonna be lifted up and be a little bit of a sexy mother here. And I want to just like totally relax your chest. You turn your face to one side and after feel deep breath, you might turn your face to the other side. Let go the weight from the chest, from the shoulders, down to the cushion, down to the ground. Relax and soften muscles around your face. From your eye sockets, your cheeks, your lips. And slowly from here, you might keep your palms down, so keep the booster away. All right, so we're gonna try to modify the downward facing dog here. So you start from all four, tuck the toes, inhale, and whenever you exhale, you lift the hip up high here. I want you to lift one leg up and lower that leg down. Then you lift, kick the other leg up and lower that foot down softly. Do it gently, smooth and slow. Kick one up and down slowly. Kick the other one up and down slowly. So give me another 4, 3, 2 and 1. And slowly from here, keep your knees soft, walk the tip of your hands towards to the knee. So keep the hands above the knee, so you won't put any tension on the knees, right? So, and keep your knees slightly bent, okay? Exhale, you lower your hands down and walk the tip of your finger forward here. And if you still remember the sexy swooping cat, so keep your knees down, rest the toe, elbows bend, lower the chest down, and now leaning forward, inhale. And when you exhale, tuck the toes and walk your hands towards to the knees. So keep your knees slightly bent and keep your hands above the knee looking straight. Exhale, lower your hands down and continue. Inhale, all four, exhale, knees down. Inhale, sexy swooping cat. And exhale. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, down. Keep continue. So. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, exhale, last one, inhale, and exhale. So keep your knees open, keep your toes touching each other, and again, you can just rest in child pose. You can using a fist, you can sitting on the booster, so many options, and do, and relax. Totally relax your entire body. For some people, they prefer to keep the forearm down, right? For me, I prefer to make a fist at my both hands and rest my forehead on the fist. So in this way, I can give the feedback immediately that my forehead totally relaxed on the fist. And I let go the weight of my head, my neck, my shoulders, down to the fist, down to the floor. And I notice that I relax my whole back from the neck bone all the way down to my tailbone. I let go the weight of my hips down to the ground. And right now, I visualize the anatomy of my own pelvic bone. I can feel that in this position, I lift my tailbone slightly off, and my both sit bone is touching the cushion. I can feel my pelvic bone touching the cushion. So in this way, I slightly open my pelvic outlet. And slowly lift your body up. All right, so from here, let's do some easy standing pose. So, come up. I know that we've been sitting for a while. Very much. So, from here, whap. All right, so what I want, again, so you face your body towards to the wall, right? And I want you to try just leaning forward and try to circle the hip. Observe, I keep my feet apart and wider than my hip. And slowly I try to circle my hip from one side to the other side. Inhale and exhale slowly. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, very good. 3, 2, and 1. Then reverse, reverse. So 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, just from here, in case if you able to go to get the ball. So actually the ball that I'm using right now, I supposed to inflate more of the air, and because of I'm moving the house, and then CJ is like, I don't know why I keep that, you know, just like he has that the pumping thing, but he has to get that the certain like a small thing that to put at between that hole. And like, when are we gonna finish this thing so I can fight? So anyway, just make sure when we sit right, you can feel that the hip still higher than your knees, and you circle the hip as well. Inhale and exhale slowly. Keep your feet flat to the floor. So 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Then reverse, reverse. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, yes, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Then you're gonna give me the pelvic tilt. So move the pelvic back and forward. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And slowly from here, I want you just like keep the elbows, all right, at your knees here. Take a deep breath. Keep the thumb close to your chest. Inhale slowly and exhale slowly. Again here, letting go your entire body weight down to the floor. Keep your eyes closed. So at this particular moment, all we need to do is to soften and relax the pelvic floor muscles. So you might observe by using your inner eyes to feel the sensation below your feet. Feel the sensation that your elbows touching at your knees. Feel the sensation of the thumb close to the chest. Now bring your full awareness to the basement of your pelvic floor muscles. Inhale, and whenever you exhale, you try to broaden, expand the diamond shape area. Let the pelvic floor muscles become more relaxed and more relaxed. Imagine you just went to the toilet. How much that you try to release and relax your pelvic floor muscles, to let go, to empty the bladder. And that's how you should feel right now. Bring your full awareness this time to your breathing. Feel the coolness of the air that goes to your nostril when you're inhaling, the warmness of the air when you're exhaling to your nostrils. And slowly open your eyes. So from here, we're gonna just do some position on the ball. So you keep your left knee bent and you keep your right leg straight. Okay, usually we modify this one from that the warrior. Actually, that if the ball is getting more stronger like you have right now, you should feel that your body should be a little bit up higher like this. So like, ooh, okay. So from here, again, I don't want you to work very much on your pelvic floor muscles, very much relaxed, yeah? So try to get the ball go to the center and support below your vagina. So you can feel like, ooh, something is touching my vagina. You might feel some pressure over here, like, oh yeah. So anyway, here, inhale, you rest your right hand up and relax the left forearm. And inhale, reverse warrior. Exhale. And inhale. So give me another three rounds. So exhale when you sigh, bending to the left. Inhale. And exhale. So one more deep breath here. Inhale. And exhale. Whoop. Five, four, hold on, three, two, and one. Because of our vagina, or I have to using the proper word, because of our groin is already being support below the ball, all right? So you should not feel that I'm keep working around here. The one that you should feel that working more probably gonna be your front leg somehow. Woo! The ball hit me. Sure. Oh yeah, I'm sure that the battery, yeah. Oh yeah.
Someone likes to play with the iPad.
Oh.
Even though it's cold, it just likes. I never opened it for them with the battery. It just likes opening the camera and taking pictures of
it. Smart kid. He gonna do everything that to make it work. So now warrior to the right side again. Try to adjust the ball and let the ball so totally support below your groin area. Like you totally relax at the basement of your pelvic floor muscles. So keep your right leg bent and keep your left leg straight. Start from here, exhale. And inhale. Exhale. And inhale. Another three rounds. Exhale. And inhale. One more time here. So hold on for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Then back to the center. All right, so from here, you're gonna lying down on your back. However, when you lying down on the back this time, we're gonna use booster again. And one cushion here. So you're gonna sit with your tailbone, with your butt very much touching the cushion, and you can feel that the sit bone touching to the floor. And slowly from here, you can see that you rest. Sometimes people feel even like very much comfortable when the incline is getting higher. Yeah. So rest from the lower back, and then you have another cushion, right, to support from the back of your head, back of your shoulder. And from here, you're like, we're gonna relax now, awesome, almost my love. So from here, I want you to keep your feet flat.
Yeah.
All right, so the moment you go down, keep it closer and closer and closer. Before you lying down, feel that your sit bone touching to the floor. Keep your feet apart, keep your knees open wide. Inhale here and exhale. I want you to lift the hip up and circle your hip from one side to the other side. Think about the weight, not even think about, it should be for your heart. So shifting the weight to the heels, and you're gonna try to circle the hip like we do while we are standing. So 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And slowly relax your hip. We do the same, but this time we're gonna reverse the circle. Inhale and exhale. So lift the hip up. And now reverse the circle, squeezing more at your butt cheeks. Shift the weight to the heels. So 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And lower your hips down. So now from here, keep the tip of your toe touching each other. And at the same time, you try to keep your knees opening. Let the gravity pulling the weight of your body down to the floor. And allow our Mother Earth, our Mother Universe, the Mother Moon, the Mother Sun, the Mother Ocean, totally taking care of this body. All you need to do is melting your body down closer and closer to the earth. Let each and every part in your body Completely relax. So the deep relaxation probably gonna be different from the sleeping at one point. So you still be conscious, be aware, and allow awesome to guide you into deep relaxation. So with your eyes closed softly and gently here, travel your mind all the way down to the tiptoes. Soften and relax all 10 toes. Let go and relax the feet, the ankle joints. Feel the sensation of side your foot and your heels, your ankle joints. Relax and make contact with the floor. Relax and let go the weight of your calf muscles, your knees, your thighs, down towards to the floor. Let the lower part of your body be closer and closer to the Mother Earth. Allow our Mother Earth to nourish each and every muscle cells on your both legs, all the way down to the hips, to your buttock. Now travel your mind to your body. Feel your lower back, your middle back, your upper back. Totally relax and make contact with this floor close to the earth. So exhale first here. And when you inhale, rest your belly, expand the belly, breathe in all the way down to the womb. And once you exhale, relax and let go the weight of your buttock, of your lower back, down to the ground. Inhale, feel your chest expand, and exhale, drop the chest, the middle back, the upper back, down to the ground. Inhale, feel the ribcage, feel the chest, feel the abdomen expand. And when you exhale, sink the body weight down towards to the ground. Relax the shoulders, relax the elbows, relax the hands, and relax the palms and all 10 fingers. Allow every breath to bring more sense of stillness, calm, and peace into your body. And now travel your mind to the upper part of your body. Relax your throat, relax your neck. Relax your jaw muscles by keeping your lips slightly apart, your teeth, your tongue, relax. soften muscles around your face, your both cheeks, your ears, your eyes, your nose. Now you travel your mind all the way to your third eye. Relax the third eye. Relax the forehead. All the way relax crown of your head. Each breath, bring your stillness, peace, and calm. At the end of each exhaling, you can feel you become more relaxed. Rest. You can feel every muscles in your body become softened and softened. Thanks to our Mother Earth to support and taking care of this body. Thanks to the Mother Ocean to allow the amniotic fluid that let the baby to stay alive and swimming freely inside the womb. Thank you to the Mother Universe and above to provide us with the air and oxygen, allow us to breathe in of love and positive energy. Allow us to breathe out of negative energy. And once again, the Mother Universe taking care of those negative energy, refreshing and return us with the positive energy. All we need, just breathe, just relax. Breathe and relax. Once your body becomes relaxed and your mind becomes stillness, travel your mind to the womb. Visualize the placenta, visualize the umbilical cord. And now visualize the size, the shape, the figure of your baby. Maybe ask your baby how your baby feel today. And yet how you want your baby to make this coming labor and birth become positive, beautiful, and memorable. And tell your baby how you feel. Tell your baby what you work on and what you want your baby to working on. As you both work as a team. And beyond that, your baby and your body know exactly when and how to be born. All we need is trust. Trust and believe in this body. Trust and believe in your capability. Trust and believe in your baby. Trust and believe in universe energy, drawing the positive energy from surrounding you into it, to your body and to your baby. Asking the Tara Goddess and Buddha surely goddess. Let the infinite space goddess and our guiding star goddess to send the positive energy and to guide us. For the best possibility to this body and to your baby. So before you keep your eyes open, once again, keep your hands in the prayer position. We not only send the gratitude to our Mother Goddess, but also send the gratitude to our own mother, to your grandmother, to your great-grandmother, to your ancestor, the one who came before us. The woman and woman and woman, million and million of women who've been through this path before us, allow them to send the positive energy to you and to your womb. And you will be the one who's sending this positive energy from womb to the next womb. And for this, I salute all the mothers, including you. And thank you so much to empower us. Thank you so much to let us to know that every woman has their own power and you are the superhero. That you already built one human being inside your womb, that the man cannot do it. So slowly from here, keep your eyes open. Now, you might just rubbing and tell your baby, hey, do what the mother telling you, hey, we work together as a team. Ping, ping, ping. And now slowly lift one knee up and you try to sailing to any side. Actually, yes, we know that we have to do a sailing more to the left. But again, go for the side that your body telling you. Your body know the best anyway. Your body just say like, can we stay in this posture just a little longer? And come up. And yet, we are done.